The 99 overall Yordan Alvarez is here from the ALCS and Championship Series program that just dropped today. And in this video, we're going to show you guys all the rewards that we can get and exactly how to get this 99 Yordan Alvarez card, because it's going to be the most sought after card, especially with that 75 fielding. So he actually gets a gold defense compared to his live series. I don't know where that compares to, but I know 75 is going to be workable, especially if you get that plus 5 for that parallel. Gets him up to about an 80 fielding, which is very, very usable for a card like this. So very good swing if you guys know the Yordan Alvarez player cards. 113 contact with 125 versus left, so it's actually a lefty killer, so a lefty on lefty killer card here, and very good versus righty, so it's gonna hit bombs. I wish we saw more, maybe like maxed out versus right too, but for this card we only get to see a maxed out contact versus left. As always, ladies and gentlemen, make sure you leave a like down below. We're only making videos right now for the most important drops in MLB The Show 21 and also players that we want to try out, which will be Yordan Alvarez and some of the other cards that's in the Championship Series program. And then World Series program's just right around the corner. It should be a good series, guys. Astros and Braves. Unfortunately, I think the Astros are going to win. That team is absolutely stacked. So that's my pick, the Astros. I know, I might get some flack for it, but the Braves are impressive. Took out my Brewers, so I'm kind of sad about that. All right, so this is the Championship Series program. So just like any of the other programs during the postseason here, you're going to have a set of missions, the conquests, and moments. We'll take a look at those in a second, but let's look at all the player cards that we can get for the Championship Series program. The first one is going to be Tyler Matzek at 98 overall. A lefty, very, very good. Has had a great postseason to date. So four-seam fastball, slider, curveball, cutter. I like those. No sinker on Tyler Matzek though. We've got a hits per nine of 124 and 125 Ks per nine. That's basically maxed out right there. Velocity is only at 89 there. Let's see his quirks real quick. A stopper, road warrior, knee buckler, cheesy, grounded, control artist, untouchable, stingy, and pressure cooker. The only place to get this card is in the Championship Series program at 30 program points. The next guy up is going to be Brustar Graterol. So we're going to get some pretty good bullpen pitchers here. Almost maxed out, basically. If you guys don't know who Graterol is, 102. Easily hits 102. So this card is definitely going to have Outlier. Yep, Outlier 1, actually. So that's kind of weird that it's Outlier 1 and it maxes out 95 plus because his sinker literally hits 102. So I don't know. I don't know how they're doing that, but I thought his sinker hit 102. At least that's how much movement he's getting, it looks like. So unless his four-seam gets that type of movement too, four-seam fastball is also going to hit 101 or so. So 123 hits per nine, 107 Ks per nine with that 99 velo and 99 break on this Brustar Graterol card. It's just unfair, man. It's just starting to get unfair here. Sinker, slider, four-seamer, and cut fastball on this card. And then we've got 99 overall Rafael Devers. I love all the Devers cards. Look at this. This honestly looks better than the Yordan Alvarez. How is that even possible? 117, 119 contact, 125 and 108 power with the 80 fielding. Can play first base. This card can play first base. This is going to be such a good card. First team with two grand slams in postseason games. So, and then you already saw the Yordan Alvarez, but the number 100 card is actually going to be Eddie Rosario, and it's better. It's absolutely better than the Yordan Alvarez card. Can play anywhere in the outfield. 125 on both sides. 120 and 113 power with 85 fielding. This card is absolutely nuts. So, I mean, all these cards in this championship series are all starter worthy, depending on how they play. So I'm excited. So how do we get all these program points? Well, if you're new here, we've got the missions, the moments, and the conquest. What I would do first is check out the mission, see where all the repeatables are. In this one, it's the postseason event. So each win, you get three total points. And then we also have a repeatable total bases from the Division Series program players. So you've had to have finished up the Division Series to be able to do this. So total bases can play on play versus CPU, and then strikeouts from the Division Series program players as well. So you got to do the Division Series, finish it up, get those players so you can do these repeatables, because this is what you're going to be able to do very, very quickly, along with the other missions that you can do offline. Everything can be done offline except the postseason events. So you've got that, right? You've got all this. You got 5, 10, 15. You've done this. You got the 20. And then you're doing the repeatables. And then you also have moments. You can get a total of 4. You can get a total of 32 by finishing up all these. So 32. And then you finish the moments, the missions. You got 52. Not doing any of the repeatables yet. So you got 52. And then say you want to do the Championship Series Conquest, that's another 30. So 82 there. And then you'll just have to do a couple of the repeatables there. But what I'm going to try to do is finish up the rest of the Division Series here for myself and just keep trying to do the repeatables, because I think that's what's going to be the fastest after doing the missions and all the moments. So we'll be doing that. I think I'm going to try to skip the conquest altogether, because that's going to take up a lot of time. So that's going to be my approach to finishing up the Championship Series. I'm going to be streaming this, so go watch me on Twitch. It might not be the Championship Series program that I'm grinding on Twitch when you do watch it, depending on when you watch this video. But that's it. There you have it. The World Series cards should be a lot better. I'm excited for that. Let's get some guesses to see like who's going to be the best players from the World Series. Let me know in the comment section down below. And then here is the updated schedule. The 26th today, we got the postseason events, the Championship Series. We've got double XP to earn your 8th inning program bosses, which is Ernie Banks, Willie Mays, and also Chris Sale. And then the 29th, we get a new player program unlock signature series legend. We've got ranked seasons to earn a milestone legend reward. And then the 2nd in November there, conquest map, a new conquest map for unlocking more 8th inning XP. But there you go, guys. Let me know what you think of these cards down below. I really want that Yordan and the Eddie Rosario. My outfield is going to start to look a little bit different here once we finish up the Championship Series program. But like I said, there you have it. Thank you all so much for watching today. I hope you enjoyed that. Catch me grinding these programs on Twitch, twitch.tv/officialatron. And as always, I'll catch you in the next one.